We begin with the cruel TV attack on a proud community. Angry families claim a promotion for the documentary called Struggle Street has humiliated them.
This is a stitch-up.
This is not a documentary. This is trash television.
Some people in Western Sydney are quite angry.
It's postcode racism at its worst.
Publicly funded poverty porn.
Absolutely furious that SBS won't listen to reason.
Do you accept that you quite deliberately humiliated these people?
Shame on you, SBS. Shame on you for attacking a suburb in the way that you have.
It needs to be just put on hold.
It's just absolutely disgraceful.
Sydney employees of SBS TV will face an unusual protest when they turn up for work tomorrow. They'll be confronted by a picket line of garbage trucks.
What's happening with the garbage trucks today, Steve?
We're heading into Tarman to SBS just to demonstrate that we believe the program is garbage, and here's the garbage trucks. We'll stop there for a couple of speeches.
Yes, the people of Sydney have decided to teach SBS a lesson by parking outside and giving boring speeches.
This is an organised, peaceful protest.
Clearly, they don't know who they're dealing with. This is a public broadcaster. We get bombarded by boring speeches all the time. This one happening right now.
The controversy over the documentary program Struggle Street reached its pinnacle today as Mayor for Blacktown Stephen Barley organised a blockade of garbage trucks to get across this important message.
The program is garbage, so we've brought garbage trucks here.
Ah, literal-minded politicians. Too bad he didn't think the show was hammy, crummy or cheesy. We could have got sandwiches delivered. Ooh.
With the show airing for the first time tonight, most of the crowd had very little idea of what they were really protesting.
What was the thing you found most offensive about the show?
I've only seen the highlights of the show.
I haven't seen a lot. Obviously, it's going to air tonight.
All it took was 1 minute and 50 seconds of promo.
Mount Druitt. It's also Sydney.
It's just been trashed.
It's getting more evident for us that the ABC and the SBS view most, well, a fair majority of Australians as just bogans.
Sure. This one-off three-part doco series really encapsulates our view on the entire nation.
Much like Channel 9 thinks we're a country of builders, Channel 7 thinks everyone's a bitchy chef, and Channel 10 thinks most Australians are a pack of teenage mermaids who should be guarding the moon pool.
It's against every mermaid law there is.
Many of Struggle Street's on-screen subjects have expressed shock at how they've been seemingly depicted by the documentary crew. They've come forward with tearful accounts of being victimised by their community and exploited by the SBS producers.
But of course, their hurt and sense of betrayal was nothing compared to that felt by any media personality with any connection to Western Sydney.
I'm pissed off deluxe when I see something like this. And for them to zero in on that particular postcode of 2770, which I proudly wear on my sleeve, not as a tattoo or anything, I proudly wear it.
Current affairs journalist Dan Nolan was so appalled SBS would air promo footage of a man farting on national TV that he decided to air it twice as many times on his own network. He even slowed it down, just to make clear how embarrassed SBS should be for showing such a thing.
I'm at home, I fart, you know what I mean? I'm not expecting people to film me and throw me on social media.
But one part of the story that got a lot of attention wasn't from the documentary itself, partly because no one's seen enough of it yet to know what to be upset about. No, the Struggle Street outrage that had everyone talking is how the thing got funded.
This program is airing on one of our publicly funded broadcasters, and it's been made with taxpayer dollars.
SBS is an organisation that primarily exists because of taxpayers' money.
Subsidised by taxpayers.
Publicly funded.
I can't believe we're able to watch such dribble on TV that is partly funded by us, the taxpayers.
Spend $1 million on this crap, it shouldn't happen.
How dare they portray shareholders of their business in such a light? Malcolm Turnbull should do something about it.
Matty John's there speaking with an unimpeachable sense of moral authority. But what a scoop! Turns out the public broadcaster's using public money to broadcast publicly. And they would have gotten away with it too had it not been for you crafty media commentators talking about it non-stop. But let's put some of this into perspective.
This is your tax dollar. In the previous financial year, the government collected $374.3 billion of these, with 0.07% of that going to your friendly neighbourhood special broadcasting service. Meanwhile, News Corp reports that each episode of Struggle Street cost about $350,000 to produce. There are three episodes, so triple that. Take off 30%, the amount SBS gets from advertising, and you're left with a total cost of $735,000 to the taxpayer. Australia has roughly 10 million taxpayers, so when you average the whole thing out, Struggle Street ends up costing each of you hard-working, heavily taxed masses about 4/5 of a cent. Yes, your not quite cent is putting TV shows on air, but it doesn't mean that you have to like or watch it. Taxpayers are also funding the military's most expensive purchase of submarines in our history. That doesn't mean that you can rock up to the docks and demand to have a go steering the things. The controversy so far has been the result of less than 2 minutes of footage, so we can only guess what response the full episode will garner. Will all this public outrage be justified, or have we just turned a molehill into a Mount Druitt? In either case, we won't have to wait long to find out.